Hey guys, we're gonna have a ponies and fairy tale talk today. I honestly, this kind of just happened yesterday, but we're gonna talk about Epitamin. I did not know what this was. Somebody asked if I can talk about it, because it's what's crazy, what's happening right now. I honestly thought it was like maybe a steroid. Like, that's how little I know of like things that you shouldn't put in your body, because I just rely on food and your basic workouts. So I went ahead and did a little bit of research on it. Before we get started, I'm going to say, I know that I cannot convince anyone not to use anything, and neither can you. When someone is stuck on doing something and they're very desperate, you can only warn them of what can happen and let them be. Let them do whatever they choose to do. I'm here to just tell you what could happen if you do take this. I can only tell you the facts. You choose to take what you choose to take out of this. And this is a couple risk factors I wanna talk about. Now, what this is, I guess it's a syrup. I don't know if it comes in a pill form. I heard it can come in a pill form. And what it does is it makes you gain weight very, very rapidly. I was reading reviews and girls were saying, oh, I gained 10 pounds in a week. Someone else, I gained 15 pounds in 2 weeks. Now, the number one thing I want to talk about when it comes to fast weight gain means it is 99.9% fat. The other 1% could be water, not muscle whatsoever. So that's a number one risk factor. And as you know, excessive fat is not good for your health. Now, even if your body weight, your BMI is in the correct range, maybe say normal, there is such a condition called normal weight obesity, which is pretty much skinny fat. Skinny fat means you look skinny to the whole world. Everyone sees you as skinny, but your body fat percentage is very high, some even around 30%, even though you are skinny to the world. Now, this usually happens because your legs are skinny, your arms are skinny, you appear petite, but you store fat in your midsection, which is the worst place you can store fat. Now, the thing with normal weight obesity is it's the same as obesity, so you still have the same risk factors: stroke, heart attack, and a lot of chronic illnesses. Now, the reason I bring this up is because I was there. I was that skinny fat girl. Everyone told me I was skinny, I didn't need to work out, but I had love handles. Terrible love handles, huge, and that's because I stored fat around my midsection, but I had very skinny legs and arms. I appeared skinny. Since this is such a big deal, not a lot of people know about it, I do warn a lot of people who want to bulk, but in my appearance, like looking at them, I know that they're skinny fat. That's why I'm always like, I need photos before I even evaluate you. Photos are a must. You can be, you know, 90 pounds and you have a lot of fat around your midsection, and then you want to bulk because your legs are skinny, which I do understand, you know, you're desperate to see size on your bottom, but the problem is that you carry a lot around your midsection, which is very unhealthy for you, and you need to tackle that before going ahead and bulking, because when you're skinny and you're 28 to 30% body fat, and then you decide to put a bulk in there, where are you gonna end up with your body fat percentage? It's not healthy. It's more that it's not healthy, and I'm like, I ain't putting anyone on an unhealthy path just because you wanna see gains in your legs and just because the world tells you you're skinny. So when I do get clients that approach me about wanting to bulk and they're not ready because I do know that they're skinny fat, I understand how important this is, and sometimes the person cannot understand because they're so set on their goal. Like what I said, they're set on a vision, they want that vision. But what I have to come around and say is, hey, listen, you have fat on you. If your fat increases, if your body fat increases, you are at risk for type 2 diabetes. You are skinny, yes. Skinny people can get diabetes too. It's about being healthy. So that's something I have to throw in there. And then a lot of times they'll fight me and fight me on it. So most of the time I know that most clients will fail on a bulk. I know that sounds bad, but it's one of those like, okay, fine, you wanna do it, let's put you on a bulk. And the minute they see the calories and try for like a week, they're like, no, this ain't for me. And I'm like, see, I told you, but we wasted a whole week on this. However, I would like to mention that a bulk is much safer than this Epitamin stuff. A bulk is saying that you are committed to work out and take that extra food and turn it into muscle, use it as an energy source, and so it's much healthier because you're not packing on bad weight. This Epitamin is literally just packing on fat, so there is a big difference. Bulking is more like, I know it's a hard journey, I warn people about it. Epitamin is, rapid fat gain. That's all that it is. Now let's look into what happens when you do gain rapid weight gain. So let's walk you guys through it. Number one is high blood pressure. Now the reason for this is your body has to work harder to pump blood throughout your entire body. Now when you gain weight, it requires even more blood, so it makes more blood. The increase of blood is what is causing pressure on the arteries, and this is where stroke and heart attack can come into play. Now the second thing is sleep apnea, and that's when extra fat tissue thickens your windpipe so you can't breathe very well. It also makes you super tired during the day, people just falling asleep. That was part of the reviews. People were saying they were getting so sleepy, falling asleep at work, feeling sleepy in the car, wanting to just full out pass out. And I thought that was insane. There are also medical conditions that come with sleep apnea. And some of them were heart failure, scary, irregular heartbeats, diabetes, stroke. So that's not something you want to mess with. I think that's pretty scary. And that's just the second one. Let's move on to the third one. And now this one is kind of scary. This is fat cells as an adult. Now for a long time, it was believed that as an adult, you no longer can gain extra fat cells. The only thing that happens is your current fat cells expand and shrink as you gain and lose. No, new research has proven this to be very false. And so what you're doing here is you're gaining rapid weight. And what I read in the reviews were people would gain it, but then lose an amount of it because they weren't staying on this, then they would get back on it, gain again. And what's scary about this and diets that are not sustainable, diets that are fast fixes and you're playing with your weight gain so much, is, let me read, this is by National Academy of Science. It's a very small study that they did on a group of people that I want to share with everyone. It says, adults can develop new fat cells. This revelation should prove insight about the risk to the risk of type 2 diabetes. The study investigated the location and composition of newly acquired body fat. It involved about 30 healthy young adults. For 2 months, they overate at every meal. They were also given supplemental treats to boost weight gain. The participants put on an average of 10 pounds. 8.5 pounds of it was fat. They also developed 2.6 billion new fat cells in the lower body. New fat cells usually didn't appear in the abdomen area, which is why the studies were going wrong so much, because they were testing kids in the tummy region as well as adults, but adults were not seeing new fat cells in the tummy. And this study was showing that they got it in their legs, in their booty, their lower half of the body. And the fat cells in the stomach just expanded, which is very not good. Oversized abdominal fat cells are a predator for insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes. So this study is showing that no, as an adult, you actually can increase your fat cells. And the problem is, once you gain fat cells, you can no longer, like, they don't disappear. They don't poof. They're gone. All you can do is shrink them. And it can get scary to the point where if you keep gaining more and more and more, eventually getting very slim is very difficult. And that's why they say as a child, obesity is so important to tackle. Weight gain is so important to tackle for a child, because if they don't stop, they're multiplying their fat cells, which means as an adult, they're going to struggle with weight for the rest of their life. I've said it plenty of times, I think it was fast progress, slow progress video of, you know, why does this person see faster progress and I don't? And there's so much to factor in, hormones and all this. But one of the big one is child obesity. Being overweight as a child means that as an adult, it's going to be much harder for you to lose that weight. You can still shrink these cells to almost nothing, but it just takes a lot longer. So that, I mean, that is scary. You don't want to mess with that. I don't think that, you know, people realize what they're doing for wanting to see quick results, you know, like I want a butt so bad I'm gonna gain 10, 15 pounds really quickly. And you have to think about how risky this is for your body. And those are the three things that they sound very fearful to me. But if for any reason the health implications do not scare you, let's talk about the cosmetic issue of this. Number one is stretch marks. Now, 10 pounds in a week doesn't even happen when you're pregnant, and they're very hard to avoid when you're pregnant. So 10 to 15 pounds in 2 weeks, it's inevitable. You are getting stretch marks. And unless you have thousands upon thousands of dollars to get them lasered off, they're permanent. That is permanent damage you have done to your body. Two, cellulite. You're gaining 99.9% fat. You're gonna get cellulite. It's just gonna happen. And you're going from being upset that you don't have the curves you want to now being upset that you're full of cottage cheese appearance skin. So you didn't really fix the problem. You got super unhealthy, and then now a cosmetic issue like a ton of cellulite that it's gonna make you miserable. Now three, you can't really pick and choose where this fat goes. You're not the 0.5% who just gains it in their boobs and butt. You're not gonna really have control over where this fat is going. So you may have a fat back, fat arms, fat legs. It's zero control over where it goes. So you have to be considerate of that. Do you want a fat chin? Is that where you're trying to get fat? Not really. So the cosmetic issue of gaining too much weight is having zero control over where that weight goes. And also the claims on the reviews were that like you can spot, what is it? Like gain? Just like you can't spot reduce, you can't spot gain. And people were saying, oh, it's my butt that grew. It's like, how? And a lot of people aren't working out, so it's like, how? How are you sending the extra fat to your butt? I would like to know. So that's one of the false things that people are claiming. And now you're just creating a bad habit. What this syrup is doing is it's increasing your appetite. So fine, it's increased, you gain a little bit of weight, you're like, woohoo. But you've already like started this habit. When does the weight gain end? When do you stop gaining weight? When does your appetite finally get suppressed? When it does get suppressed, you lose all the weight. And something I was trying to find about how this affects your hormones, there's no evidence to back it up. I couldn't find anything on it, but you have to understand gaining 10 pounds and then a girl got off of it, lost the 10 pounds. Doing that to your body, I'm pretty sure it's messing with your hormones. I just couldn't find any evidence behind it, any science-based evidence, but I'm like 99% sure your hormones are being affected in one way or another. So that's the cosmetic issues. If you like stretch marks, cellulite, fat gain in unwanted areas, and you're willing to create a very horrible habit for your health, I guess it's something you should be interested in. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't hate this syrup. I think it's actually important to have something like this. I think it's good for people who have eating disorders, people whose body fat percentage is so severely low it is bad for their health. They're on the road to recovery. They need something to increase their appetite. This is something a doctor would be able to prescribe you naturally, a syrup that increases appetite. I think it's great for people who are very sick and they have no appetite and their health depends on them eating, but they have no appetite whatsoever. This is something for them. And I think it's being misused and advertised as a glamorous thing to ingest for fast weight gain. And I just want to remind people of the risk of gaining weight this fast. And the reason for it is when so many people are talking about it, and oh, look, girls, I feel so confident now. Like, nobody thinks about the risk factors. Nobody waits and says, hey, 10 pounds in a week, let me think about this, it sounds bad. Nobody waits to like think about that because they're getting so influenced and they're desperate for fast results. And honestly, the only gain, the only healthy weight gain is muscle. There is no such thing as gaining a bunch of fat and that being healthy, unless I said, like I said, if your body fat percentage is so low that your health is in jeopardy, then that fat gain is the only fat gain that's gonna be healthy for that individual. But the only way to gain a healthy amount of weight is through building muscle. And the max amount you wanna gain in a week is 0.5 pound to 1 pound, and 1 pound is pushing it. But 0.5 pound is pretty much the route you wanna take. Now, keep in mind, this is completely different. Bulking, epitamin, I keep forgetting what it's called. Completely different. Bulking is choosing to live a healthy lifestyle, work out, have a set workout regimen, because you cannot decide to bulk and not work out. Again, that you're just gaining fat then in that case. But bulking is you're choosing to change your body composition, put on healthy weight,
building muscle,
which in the long run is really good for you, because as you age, the more muscle you have, the more mobile, the more healthy you are. You know, you're not that 50-year-old that can't lift their hands up over their head or pick something up. So your risk factors as you get older decline because of all the muscle you have in your body. So that is healthy. But people are choosing to gain fat just for curves, it's not going to be healthy. Now, I know I'm going to get hate for this because, you know, when someone loves a product or wants results, they're going to find a reason to hate the video. Don't be mad. I'm just here to tell you the facts of it and the risk factors. If you want to do it still, it's not my business. You know, I'm not going to tell someone they shouldn't do it, wouldn't call them out, wouldn't say anything, because hey, mind your own business. This is just, if you're thinking about it and you want to know, is there a problem if I do this? This is the video telling you, yeah, there are risk factors if you do gain fat rapidly.
It's the same thing as using steroids.
Same thing as using steroids, but I don't know. The fat gaining almost seems worse. I don't know. Let me juggle it for a little. Let's just say they both equal an unhealthy lifestyle and they own you. Fat will own you. Steroids will own you. If you get on steroids, you really can't get off of it. If you do get off of it and you're a big shot, you're going to lose all your followers because you're going to deflate. You're not going to like it. So you're going to stay on it until it takes over your life. So they're both very unhealthy things. I'm just here to warn you guys against it. I'm not trying to keep girls from getting to their goal body because the reviews were insane. There was a girl who was 4'10", 145 pounds. You curvy. We know you curvy, you know? You're 4 pounds under me and a foot smaller than me. We know you curvy. She wants to be 165. That is obesity for a 4'10". And all of it to be fat gain. It's obesity at that point. You don't care about your health. It's sad. And if you have kids, you should be ashamed of yourself. You should be absolutely disgusted and ashamed of yourself for not taking care of your health. It's like me choosing to become unhealthy while I have a daughter who depends on me solely, needs me, loves me, and I'm choosing to get sick. You know, it ain't right. It's not right. Just like somebody who ignores symptoms of being sick. I told you guys, my mom died when I was 2. When I tell the doctors what she died from, they're in shock. Why? This is so preventable. Because she ignored the symptoms. Having 7 kids was not motivating enough for her to go to the doctor, figure out what was wrong, fix it, stop popping a kid every year, because that was our ages are 1 year apart. It never dawned on her that you're putting so many lives, you're bringing so many lives into this world, and you're not taking care of yourself. I don't get that. So that's going a little too deep, my bad. The point is, take care of yourself. It's the only body you get to live in. And if you have people depending on you, take care of yourself. That's all I gotta say. If you hate on this video, it just means that you don't care for your life or the life of others. If you're either the supplier or you just really want to use it, it's fine. The only reason I brought this up was because it was brought to my attention, and honestly, I felt bad not talking about it. I didn't want to at first, and he even said we shouldn't talk about it because when people get so stuck in something, it becomes a religion and they get very angry. But you know what? I felt, let me just do my part. Let me tell people about the risk factors of rapid weight gain and what it could happen to them if they do take this route. And so, you know what? I don't feel bad. It's off my chest. But for me, it's about giving you guys the information. And you guys can take it how you want it.
It was yesterday's comment.
And it was, yeah, somebody commented yesterday. And it was just one of those, like, I was going to show you guys my workout and Monday's recipe. But then I was like, it sat really heavy because if this is a new trend, I should probably address this. You know, like, it just felt like I needed to. And even though he was like, I don't know, it doesn't seem like something we should be talking about. I was like, but ponies and fairy tales needs to have this topic. So for you guys, we did it.
We read all the comments.
And thank you for all your support, guys. We appreciate it. Anyways, guys, we're gonna end the vlog here. We are posting Monday's recipe. It's just gonna be in a different vlog. It's still going up today as well. Go ahead and enjoy that video. Hope you guys like it. Vegan style friendly. Anyways, if you enjoyed it, do give it a thumbs up. It motivates me to do more like these. It reassures me that you guys want ponies and fairy tale talks. If you're not already subscribed, be sure to do so. And until next time, bye, guys.